Good morning, children. Welcome to another session of SST. Today, we'll continue with lesson number 6, Domains of the Earth. Last time, we had studied about the 4 domains of the Earth and the continents. Today, we are going to learn about the oceans, main oceans. 5 oceans are there. Today we'll learn about them. So, first we'll see the map and I'll let you know where they are located, and after that we'll learn about them in detail. So children, see here, as you can see in this map, here Arctic Ocean is there. See the location. I'm going to explain you the location. It is on the northern hemisphere. It is in the northern hemisphere of the Earth, Arctic Ocean. This is northern hemisphere. This is southern hemisphere. So, in southern hemisphere, southern ocean is there. This southern ocean is also called Antarctic Ocean. Antarctic Ocean, as it is near the Antarctica continent. So it is also called Antarctic Ocean. Now come to the Pacific Ocean, which is the biggest and the deepest ocean on the Earth. It is divided by equator. Where is equator? Here. This is equator. It is divided into North and South Pacific Ocean. This is equator. Above the equator is North Pacific Ocean and this is South Pacific Ocean. Under the equator, this side, it is South Pacific Ocean. Clear? Now comes North Atlantic Ocean. This is Atlantic Ocean. Can you see Atlantic Ocean? This is Atlantic Ocean. This is South Atlantic Ocean, North Atlantic, South Atlantic Ocean. Now comes Indian Ocean. This is the only ocean which is named after a country, India. Okay, so this is another ocean. Have you all understood? Now we'll just do the reading and learn about these oceans in detail. Hydrosphere. Hydrosphere, the Earth is often called the blue planet. You all know this. Earth is called the blue planet. 71% of Earth's surface is covered with water and 29% with land. So, it is not that only water in the oceans is counted in hydrosphere. Water in all the three forms is counted in hydrosphere. Like solid, liquid and gas. All the three forms of water. What are they? Like ice is the solid form. So all the glaciers and all, they are the ice is there, no? So that is also counted as water. And in the atmosphere, it is present as gas. So that is also counted in hydrosphere only. So 71% of Earth's surface is water. Water in the seas and all rivers, that is also the liquid form. So that is also counted. Understood? Now comes this oceans. Most of the water on the Earth is oceans, is in oceans. There are 5 oceans. The Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Southern or Antarctic Ocean and the Arctic Ocean. I've shown you everything in the map. Now, let us read about them in detail. Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean in the world. It is divided into 2 parts by equator. North and South Pacific. Ferdinand Magellan gave the Pacific Ocean its name. Understood? हु गेव दिस नेम पैसिफिक ओशियन? फर्डिनेंड मैगेलन. एंड इट्स मीनिंग इज वॉट? द पीसफुल सी. पीसफुल सी. एंड विच इज द डीपेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ? That is Mariana Trench. Mariana Trench, which is located in this ocean only, deepest part. Clear? Mariana Trench. This you have to learn. Mariana Trench. Now comes Atlantic Ocean. This is the second largest ocean after Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean. It is surrounded by North and South America on the western side and Europe and Africa on the eastern side. Clear? The coastline of Atlantic Ocean is highly indented. Indented means divided with an irregular line. Means line is not there, but simply curved line is there which divides this ocean. It has natural harbors and ports. Here so many ports are there for trade and commerce. Means many things are uploaded here and sent to various countries from the ports, harbors. Okay. So this thing I can show you again here. Now North and South America. See here, North Atlantic Ocean is there. It is surrounded by North and South America on this side, and from this side Europe and Africa on the eastern side. Clear? Turn the page and come to this page, Indian Ocean. This you all know, it is the only ocean named after a country, that is India. It is the third largest ocean. In north it is bound by Asia, and in west by Africa, and in east by Australia. See children, you have understood the directions. I made you understand all the directions earlier. So can you see again? See here. This is Indian Ocean. This is Indian Ocean. So, what all sides it has? This is east, west, north and south. So, here nothing is there. Or you can say, this is east, west, north and south. So, east side Australia is there. North, Asia continent. And here, west side, Africa is there. Understood? Clear to you? So, this way, you understand on your own. No need to mug up the things. You have to understand and write. This map should be in your mind. Where this ocean is there and what all continents surround them. So, that way only you can explain when in question answers anything is asked to you. Now comes Southern or Antarctic Ocean. Southern Ocean is also called Antarctic Ocean. It encircles the continent of Antarctica. Sometimes it is considered merely a part of the Atlantic, Indian and Pacific Ocean. It is a very cold ocean with floating icebergs. Here ice is only there. Understood? See here, floating icebergs. Penguins and all, they all live here only at very cold place. Polar bears and all. Now comes Arctic Ocean. Arctic Ocean is around the North Pole of the Earth. It is the smallest and the shallowest ocean. Shallowest means not deep. It is not very deep. So it is the shallowest ocean. It is mostly surrounded by Asia. It is mostly surrounded by Asia, Europe, and North America. The water of the Arctic lacks salinity. Salinity means salty. The water is not that salty and is mostly frozen throughout winter. Throughout winter, it is frozen. Means ice is there. Life on Earth greatly depends upon the huge water bodies. So seas are also part of five oceans. Seas are smaller than oceans but greater than rivers. Understood? Bigger than, I mean. Now comes the atmosphere. What is atmosphere? It is the layer of gases that surrounds the air. You can't see air, but you can feel air. So the atmosphere is made up of what? It is made up of nitrogen mostly, 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 1% other gases. What are those gases? Argon, carbon dioxide, neon, helium, hydrogen and other gases. Oxygen is also there. So oxygen is needed by we all, humans and animals. But what do the plants need? Tell me. Plants need carbon dioxide. Yes. We release carbon dioxide and plants take them. And plants release oxygen, which is taken by us. That's why we are told to plant more and more trees so that we can get more and more oxygen, fresh air. The Earth's atmosphere is divided into five layers. Five layers are there. See here, diagram is there. Troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. These are the five layers of the earth atmosphere. The troposphere is the layer next to the ground or the surface of the earth. That is where we live and planes fly. Clear? Now comes the different layers of the atmosphere. What is the significance of these layers? How do they help us? These layers help us in many ways. They absorb heat from the sun and keep the heat inside the atmosphere, helping the earth to stay warm, called the greenhouse effect. You might have learnt about greenhouse effect in science. So this heat from the sun is absorbed by this atmosphere. So that the earth remains warm. Clear? It keeps the overall temperature stable, especially between day and night. Stable means does not change, remains consistent. So the temperature remains consistent, especially between day and night. The ozone layer in the atmosphere helps to protect the earth from the sun's radiation. Sun's radiation is harmful also. So, ozone layer is there in the atmosphere which protects us from this harmful radiation. Clear? Now comes biosphere. Biosphere is the sphere or area around the planet Earth where life exists, means where we live. It includes everything living on the earth, including humans, animals, plants and insects. The area where we are living, that is biosphere. The layer of the earth containing life is thin, means it is very less place. The upper atmosphere has little oxygen and very low temperature, while ocean depths greater than 1000 meters are dark and cold. In fact, it has been said that biosphere is like the peel in relation to the size of an apple. Understood? Means biosphere is very little place, like the peel of an apple. That much thick only. With this, we come to the end of the chapter. I hope you all have understood it. Is it clear to you? Children, you read the chapter again. Don't mug it up. You have to understand the map and then you can write on your own which continent is surrounded by which other continent, where is the location of this sea, or what all continents surround a particular sea. So children, just have a look. And you just go through it once again so that you are able to memorize the things. Understood? And learn the brain gain also. That you have to learn. Okay. I hope you all will complete your work also.